Jacqueline Coley with Rotten Tomatoes. Come on out, let's get the panel going.
All right, everyone. Without further ado, please allow me to welcome to the stage the cast and producers of Teen Wolf, Jeff Davis, Tyler Hoechlin, and Tyler Posey. Gentlemen, come on out. I just have to say, as someone that has watched the show, I did start this job after the show finished, so I've been very... Whoa. Easy now.
Oh yeah, we're dark.
Yeah, we can't see
We're them. Brooding is what's going on here.
But now we can see all of you.
Yeah. We're going to be brooding. They'll get it. I did want to start here because if you came here from Tumblr days, we're home. That's all I have to say. And I feel that was like the kickstart of all of this. And so like looking back on it, like why do you feel this fandom is so loyal that I literally had so many people talking to me when they found out I was moderating this. 5 years and one day from the last Comic-Con panel, folks are back here to be here for this film. I mean, Jeff, you would know, why do you think this fandom is so deep?
It's the writing.
Nothing to do with the show.
The flawless narrative construction.
You're right, dude.
No, it's the characters. It's always the characters. Getting to see these guys interact. It's seeing Lydia, Holland.
There we go.
It's seeing Crystal Reed as Allison. It's seeing these two guys, my two Tylers, as Derek and Scott. That's why people come back. That's why I always come back to TV shows myself.
Oh, I love it. I do have to go ahead and say this. The Teen Wolf fandom, I know for a fact, has been asking for this moment. And I would also say that Tyler Posey, sir, you've been like egging them on at every red carpet. I got a like, F yeah, a couple times when people start asking you. It's your panel, sir. You can say whatever you want. But I will say, like, why do you think now is the time for you to come back to this character? What about this character made you want to come back and do it as a film?
I mean, yeah, like you said, I've been an advocate for bringing Teen Wolf back ever since, before we even ended. Like, I knew it was going to end at some point. I was like, I need this shit back immediately. And I think, I don't know. I mean, first of all, I'm in the best place I've ever been in my entire life, you know? So it just feels cool. It just feels serendipitous that the show is back right now, you know? We took a long enough step away from it to really appreciate it and miss it, you know? The show consumed our lives for 10 years, you know? And we were just constantly busy filming the show. And so, like, I think we all needed a break, you know? As much as we would have loved to keep going, it's nice. And it just creates this, it's just special now, you know, bringing it back to everybody, and it's just, I think this amount of time was perfect. I think any longer people would have forgotten the show, you know, right?
Yeah, no, it's fair.
They never,
no, never, you never would have forgotten it?
Okay. Well,
I love you guys!
Oh! Love this. Tyler, I do have to say this. What can folks somewhat expect? Because we're going to show a teaser trailer in case.
Holy shit.
Maybe.
If you're good.
We may show you some. But what can they look forward to?
It's literally this movie, the Teen Wolf movie, is everything the fans want. It's the entirety of the show wrapped up into one movie. It's nostalgic. It's every character that you ever want to see ever again. And the cast has grown up. We're grown up now, just like every single one of you guys. You know, we started the show. I was 18, and now our characters are in their 30s. You know, so it's a whole new side of Teen Wolf. There's no teens anymore.
I was just about to get into that. Well, also, I will have to say before we do any more, but just looking back, Mr. Hoechlin, everyone's done so many great things, but I want to give at least a moment to look back. And I know you guys love Comic-Con, but from your days on set, do you have a particular memory that you were sort of thinking about, maybe driving down here, coming back to Comic-Con and stepping back into this sort of the wolf pack, as they say?
So many good memories, a lot of incredible years together. But honestly, it was Comic-Con. We've always had such a great time here. I've told the story before, but the first time we were here, no one wanted us here. They were very mad that we were doing the show. And then the second time we came back, there was such a warm welcome from everybody, and the show had finally kind of been out in the world then. So from that time on, I think we had like 5 or 6 years in a row that we were here. And every single season, it was just kind of great to see how the show had grown and how the fans were becoming more and more involved with these characters. So this has always been a really special place for us to come back to. So I'm glad it's been a few years now, but we're back, and it's awesome.
So glad you're back. Also, Tyler, glad you got out here without injuring yourself, because apparently every Comic-Con you get injured.
Like, yeah, whenever I come out, when they announce my name, I like to, you know, make you guys laugh and be happy or whatever, and I did it. I broke my toe 1 year on this stage. Yeah, and then I poured like a bottle of water on myself at one point. This time I stood on the chair. I hope it was worthy. I hope it was still.
We were at press afterwards, and I'm like, are you all right? And he's like, no, I'm in excruciating pain.
It hurt.
I feel bad asking Jeff like what your favorite memories are, because in truth, I know you were a working writer during that time. So like, yes. No matter what the greatest day was, there's probably a script you were like stressing about, or like a line of dialogue. But do you have one that you hold particularly dear from those days on set?
I have so many. And I have some new memories too from the film that I can tell you about later if you want.
Yes.
But God, I remember shooting the pilot. It's not always the best memories that you hold on to. It's sometimes the worst. And our first day was an absolute disaster. The camera broke down. It was freezing. We realized nobody knew anything about lacrosse, and that's what we were shooting that day. I certainly didn't.
Yeah, speak for yourself. And a trailer caught on fire.
Yeah, and the trailer caught on fire. Actually, the trailer caught on fire about the third day, I think.
Oh, really?
I remember posting something about it saying, hair and makeup trailer on fire, all is going well.
Yeah.
Wow.
But I will say, one of my favorite memories was the last day of shooting. Because you do, as a writer, you work constantly on a TV show. I can't remember who said this, but somebody once said, trying to write a TV show is like trying to land a crashing 747 once a week.
That's the scariest analogy ever.
Yeah.
But hell.
Actually, my favorite quote about writing is, writing for TV is like having homework for the rest of your life. That's Lawrence Kasdan said that. The last day of shooting, because so many people came up to me that day who had worked on the show, and people came back that day who hadn't been on the show in a while to watch the last day of shooting, and everybody said, this was one of the best jobs I've ever had, and when you work on something next, please hire me and pay me more.
I feel you on that one. I will say, when you guys jetted off into the sunset in 2017, that was my very first Comic-Con here. They barely let me in the door. Definitely didn't let me in Hall H. But I said, okay, well, I'm never gonna get to see Teen Wolf in Hall H. I'm never gonna get to see them at Comic-Con because the show is over. And then you came back, and so I get to be here. So excited. And you're doing it in a movie. So everything gets bigger. Everything gets, like I would say, expanded upon. So Jeff, why a movie? Why sort of bringing it back and not with another season to have this sort of longer form story?
Well, I told Paramount Plus I absolutely can't do another season. And they said, what about a movie? And so I started writing the movie, actually. We started plotting it together. Me, Russell, Joe, just putting together ideas, and Will, one of our writers. I realized we were writing a very long movie because we essentially have 20 main characters. And once I finished the script, it was about 138 pages, and I realized I wrote a short season 7. So we'll see how much of that lasts in the final cut, but it was really amazing to like bring all the characters back and to revisit them and see where they are now, because we do actually take a jump in time. Tyler and I were talking earlier, and Tyler, for the first time, his character is older than Tyler is.
Yes, my character is now older than I am. I've never been the same age as Scott. When we first started, he was 15, I was 18, and now he's like 55, and I'm 30.
And we didn't use any makeup.
Yeah, no, because I look old.
That is very disingenuous, sir. I watched the entire season over the weekend. Not that much, okay? I'll just say, you moisturize well. The only thing you can tell is with the tattoos. That is definitely the line of like...
Right, yeah, even my ass is covered in tattoos.
I will tell you that for this movie, I didn't write any of the tattoos into the movie.
Oh, you did?
Season three.
You're just like...
He had one tattoo in season three, and I was like, all right, we're not covering it up every day. I'm going to write it into the show.
Right,
somehow.
These guys, the stripes. Yeah, remember the stripes? Yeah.
And then he just kept getting them.
Can't stop.
So he just wears long sleeves all the time now.
It's true. It's the greatest. I don't have to show my naked body anymore on TV.
I will say, backstage in the green room, I saw when, you know, the Tylers came together, and I'm literally like, oh, if 13-year-old me could see this, she would lose it. But I will say this, what was it like for y'all reuniting? What was it like for you to have that moment where you guys saw each other, maybe in hair and makeup, maybe in the wolf costume, or just, hey, we're doing this again. When did you guys know both of you were coming back and you're gonna be doing it together? Hickel, I'll start with you, sir.
Not too long before shooting, actually. It was like right before shooting. I remember calling him and we FaceTimed and caught up for a minute and just kind of talked about it. And then my first day on set was the first day that we shot. And I had a few things early on in the morning that he wasn't in. But then eventually, you know, he showed up, and I'm not going to say who, but a few other people showed up. And it was just... It's great. I have so many of my best friends are from this show, genuinely. So I've seen a lot of them, you know, consistently since we finished the show. But to see everybody back on set, like at the trailers, getting hair and makeup done, getting into wardrobe, and calling them by their character name again was such a crazy trip down memory lane and making new memories that it was really special. So I think Posey and I probably hugged each other like 50 or 60 times that first day. I think I said I love you to him more than I've ever said it to my family.
Like, we are a family.
And we say it a lot. I'm a close family. But like, it was just, it really was. It was such a special day to see that it actually happened. Because I mean, so many times people want these things to happen and they plan for them and they try. But it's not usually easy to get anything actually made or greenlit sometimes. And so to get everybody back with schedules and everything, it was just, yeah, it was the greatest.
Yeah, dude, speaking of, your schedule was insane. You had like a rock star schedule. He was flying to and from three different jobs that were all while filming Teen Wolf. And so like, when we were filming, when we were in the thick of it, you know, I got kind of used to filming, and it felt like no time had gone by at all. It was really trippy. And then when he would show up on set, all these emotions and memories would flood back to me, and it just felt special.
Yeah.
Like you said, so you really helped bring this like, nostalgic vibe back every time I saw you. It's true. I love him.
Yeah.
I love him so much. I hate Derek, but I love him.
I can tell one story about seeing them back together again, too. We had started doing wardrobe fittings, and they came to the office, and I was still writing the script, of course. And so I had, it was Tyler, Colton, and JR, and they came up to my office, and I said, come here, let's read some scenes. And they hadn't read the script yet. I just told them a little bit about it. And when we started reading the scenes together, it was like we all had sort of tingles because it felt like there was a resurgence of magic in the air.
There really was, man. This whole entire experience, I got chills the entire time. It's so fucking cool. It's really, so cool.
I really do love that the fandom has aged with your ability to be like, give it. Like,
yeah. I still swore a lot on these things, but now you guys can swear with me.
Fuck yeah!
Oh, that's right. In the movie, they're swearing.
We say fuck in Teen Wolf the movie. How cool
is
that?
That's what I was trying to get to. I would say that's maybe the most surprising thing, that you curse, but Tyler P, is there anything else that you were surprised that you got to do this time around that you couldn't do on the show?
Pass the torch to another team. You know, we have Eli Hale, who is Derek's son, you know? So I was finally an adult, and it felt really good to kind of step into that role. And I didn't have to show my naked body, which was really cool too. So.
I mean...
There might be one scene where you see my chest.
I was just about to say, are we really going to get through the whole thing without at least a peek?
There's definitely a peek, for
okay.
sure.
Okay. I'm definitely just, a peek. I'm, you know, for the plot, lady.
Yeah, no, of course.
Mr. Tyler H. Sir, also, you came back for season 6 recurring, but you also had some distance between your original run on the show, and so it's almost maybe like deja vu. Was it like that time when you came back, or was it even more removed coming back for the film?
Somewhat similar, but I would definitely say different, because I knew that you know, everybody else had still been doing the show consistently when I left the first time, so there was a bit of a coming back to close it out, and that was really fun. That was its own thing. But I think with this, we've all had our time since then. So everybody had kind of gone and experienced life without Teen Wolf for a little bit. So it felt much more, I don't know, it felt more like a shared experience as opposed to my experience coming back to the show. So it definitely felt a little bit different in that sense. So it's been, like you said, I think just coming back to these characters in such different places in their lives, and we're at different places in our lives than when we left. There's just something special about that.
Jeff, I wanna leave it with you real quick to just sort of talk about like overviewing exactly what folks can see, but I do have to just maybe get Tyler P to say, where do we find Scott at the beginning of this? Because I think that's where folks really wanna know, just where are we seeing him? Because the fact that he's 50 already blows my mind.
He's 50 years old, he's got grandbabies, grandwolves, just joking. Okay, so Beacon Hills kind of messed Scott up, and I think along with everybody here, you know, Beacon Hills was a fucking wild ride. Right? Crazy shit happened there. It sucked, okay? It aged me 50 years. And so Scott wanted to step away. So he lives in Los Angeles now. He wanted to get away from Beacon Hills. He wanted to put the leadership role on the shelf for a little while. So when we pick up with him, he's kind of a normal person. You know, he still works at the vet. And he is lonely. You know, he's like, he's an adult. He's going through what all of us have gone through as adults. You know, he's dealt with some really serious moments in his life, you know, with Beacon Hills, but stepping away, he deals with the reality of what it is to be an actual human, you know? And instead of a superhero werewolf saving the world constantly, he now has to figure out how to save himself. And so that's kind of where we pick him up. He's a little more relaxed. He's not so focused on saving the world yet, you know? But it's a really, we've never seen Scott like this ever in our entire career with Teen Wolf. So I was really happy to present that and play that. So I hope you guys like it. It's really cool.
Is it fair to say that we find Scott like right after his quarter life crisis? Because that math kind
of
works out.
I think we're right in the middle of it.
You know, like right in the middle of it?
Yeah,
okay.
I think we're right in the middle of it. We just bought a convertible.
Yeah.
He grew a mustache. Yeah. You know? He's definitely right in the middle of a quarter life crisis.
Yeah,
got a bunch of tattoos.
I feel that.
On his butt.
Jeff, I will say a lot of things have changed just with technology since you guys did the film. There's so many things. What do you think you got to do just from access, you guys having more time with things? I know television, like you say, is such a sprint. You had more time with this. What was something you got to explore this time around that you couldn't just based on the TV constraints?
I bought a drone, which was nice. So we got to use the drone. But as for filmmaking, we were pretty much the same. We shot Teen Wolf. We tried to make a movie every week. So we were way too ambitious for our budget. And I think we were probably way too ambitious for our budget this time as well, even though we had a little more. But yeah. The real fun of it for me was getting them back together and seeing where the characters were in their lives this time, and also asking the question, what happened to them? Where are they now? And I think we came up with some good ideas. And actually, we also introduced a few interesting new characters too, which I think you're gonna get to.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, I think folks have already spied just from the stuff that Paramount Plus has already released. We've been like eagle-eyed spotting in what we can and who's there. So can you tell us about some of these new faces that we've seen glimpses of?
Yes, one of them is played by Vince Mattis. He plays Derek Hale's son, Eli. And it was an exhaustive search to find him. One of the interesting things about the movie as well is both Tylers are producers on it. And we brought Hecklin in to help find his son, in the movie, and he did all the auditions with the kids and directed them, actually. You can talk about it better than me.
Yeah, really fun. I've been lucky to do this as my job since I was a kid, since I was like 8 or 9 years old. So I've been on the other side of that so much. Jeff was very gracious to really, part of coming in and producing was something that I've been around this business a lot, and I didn't want it to be something where it's just a credit, but I really wanted to participate. And so that was like an early conversation for him and I was like, I want to earn this. I want to be a part of it. So with the casting process, I got to watch all the tapes for the new characters and specifically for Eli. Going through those, and I saw Vince, and just for whatever reason felt like he was the guy. And we read a lot of really talented young actors. Jeff was kind enough to let me direct them in our little chemistry reads that we did over Zoom, because it was still COVID and all that stuff. So it was really fun, but Vince was just such a great kid. He did such a great job on the film. I'm so proud of him, and we were lucky to have him. So it was fun to be on the other side of the camera and to be able to know what they were going through as young actors, and trying to give them as much as I could to make them feel comfortable and guide them in a way that would, let them do their best work. So again, we're just very lucky to have Vince. He did a fantastic job. So
would you say, as a former child actor, you in particular are more protective of them? Because I would guess that that's the case. Like, you are just like, I hold a special place in my heart for kid actors.
Yeah, I don't know if it's more protective, but I think there's just there's a shared experience there. Like I said, I know what it's like to be in their shoes. I know how nerve-wracking it can be. It's different now. I've never done a Zoom chemistry read. That was the first experience for all of us. But being on that side,
you were the Tom Hanks.
Yeah. No, that was, met him in the room, and that was that was it. But it's definitely that experience. But yeah, that to me was the same thing. I remember how gracious Tom was when I worked with him on Road to Perdition, and Paul Newman. I had really great examples when I was a kid, and I'm very, very lucky for that. And talking about that film, that's usually what I refer to now, is how grateful I am to have had those examples and mentors when I was that young. So I've tried to pay that forward and pass it on the best I can, so.
I do love that. Well, I kinda let y'all know a little bit. We might have a little bit of footage.
Hey, are you guys excited to see this trailer?
I know. That is not what I expected for a teaser trailer for Teen Wolf. So let's hear it again. Are you ready to see this trailer?
There you go.
All right.
What the fuck?
Okay. So for everyone in the audience is like, when they gonna talk about Allison? When they gonna talk about Allison? We've come to the Allison section, ladies and gentlemen.
She looks pretty badass up there, huh?
That trailer was absolutely, absolutely insane. I do have to start with this. Like, first and foremost, Allison's death, we know, weighed very heavily on Scott Tyler.
Yes.
We know that was just a huge part of his incredible arc over the 6 seasons. So what do you feel this is going to impact, sort of like bringing her back? And what does it feel like to reunite with Crystal Reed as well?
Yes, fucking awesome, honestly. This was the beginning of Teen Wolf. This is where all of our love and passion for this show started, and she was just as much a part of it as we were. And so being able to work with her again just brought everything back, and it was just perfect. It was exactly what we wanted as a show. We wanted to be there with each other from the very beginning. And so as an actor, getting to work with her again was awesome, And like we've grown up since we've really hung out with each other, and so like finding out that like our interests are similar and just getting to know her again as a person was just awesome. But for Scott, it fucking rocks his world, dude. He's like, what the fuck? He doesn't really know what to think. And you'll see, like, it's, I can't, it's hard to say much because I can't get
I will it. Leap across this table.
he literally leaned in the minute we started talking about her, y'all.
He will kill me, but it's, you gotta watch it. It's not anything what you would think.
The other thing
is that okay, Jeff? So scared. I'm so scared.
He's got the desert. Don't say nothing. Tyler H., I will say, in this, we got to see you back in the makeup, both you and Tyler P., and I know makeup advances like everything else, but I do have to say, it looks really good. Like, I feel like they upped it. Was it the same process with Transformation, or was it different?
Our same guys who are just awesome. I think the process in making the new pieces, there might have been something different to it, but overall it felt very similar to what we had on the show, and it's a testament to those guys. We had such amazing people working on the show with our crew, and you know, Chris and Eric and those guys, they're just such pros. So we're really lucky to have them back and to do it again. And it was, going back into the makeup, putting the fangs on again. It was weird because it had been a long time, but it also somehow felt like, oh yeah, we did this yesterday. It was really strange how much time had passed, but it just kind of felt like riding a bike. So it was good to go back.
I did want to ask this too, because I got to see the trailer and I'm like, been getting ready for this panel, and I was just thinking, I want to like scream to everyone that I'm near, like, did you know? Like, this is happening again, and I'm all excited. How did you two keep the secret? Because there's a lot of things in this movie that are...
Jeff has instilled it in us that if we leak anything, he will fire us. He doesn't give a shit if we're the leads of the movie. He'll find another one.
Well, listen, though.
There's some kid on TikTok who looks exactly like him.
I know, yeah. There's a kid on TikTok who looks just like me, so, you know, you can recast if you want to.
I've watched his TikToks, and I'm like... He could do it.
No! Stop!
Also, you know, it's fun for us for you guys to be surprised, you know? So it's as much as it kills us to hold secrets in like this, it's fun to watch your reaction, like what just happened, you know? Like, that was the biggest scream of the day when you saw Allison come back. Like, that was so cool.
And I was just gonna ask you, Jeff, I think obviously as a writer, when you put characters to bed, even in a universe where, let's be honest, nothing is ever really dead, I feel like you feel like a certain, like, I've put this character, this was their arc and everything else. What was it like for you re-exploring all the dynamics that you thought you had left with Allison when she left the show, bringing them back for these characters after they've gone through what she wasn't a part of?
It was exciting, but also I wanted to make sure that I did the character justice. And then I got the voice correct again. Because I had to go back and start looking at scenes in the show. I'd forgotten. I had to rely on some other people, like, did we do that? What did we do there? And it was fun because when we were piecing together the whole storyline, we would start watching scenes from the show, and then we'd keep watching. And we'd all look at each other and be like, hey, our show was pretty good. But having her back was amazing, and I remember I texted Crystal. She had texted me and saw the announcement, and I said, well, we don't really have a story yet. I mostly have ideas, but I always said if I was gonna do a movie, one of the characters I would bring back is Allison. How would you feel about picking up the bow and arrow again? And she texted me back that she just burst into tears, and then we talked on the phone for half an hour, and I told her some of my ideas, and she was in right from the first moment.
Oh, I love that so much. We're gonna take it to you guys next, so for the folks waiting for an audience Q&A, we got to see a little bit of Vince in the trailer, and yes. So you've definitely talked about being on set with him and working with him, but like playing a father from you, what was that like for you? Because I do know that's a shift for actors, like, you know, especially you having so many great guys that played your dads on screen.
Yeah, definitely. I've had a little bit of practice on another show, which helped out a little bit.
What show?
It helped out a little bit. I think there's some posters around. No,
I love it. I've been walking around San Diego. There's Tyler.
Yeah, it's a little strange. But no, obviously I've been playing it for two seasons on another show. But it was different here with this character. There's certain rules to Superman and Clark Kent for sure. Did we not know that's what I was talking about?
I need to talk a little bit about this too, because Superman was, the movie was a huge influence on my life and becoming an actual filmmaker. And I remember my twin brother Scott called me and he's like, have you been watching Superman and Lois? I'm like, no, I've seen glimpses of it, but he's like, you gotta watch this. He said, and he says to me, I think he's the best Superman.
Yeah!
My brother, we're both crazy about Superman too, about Christopher Reeve. And I said, hold on, you're saying he's better than Christopher Reeve? And my brother Scott's like, I think he's better than Christopher Reeve.
I
started watching him and I was like, oh my God, he really is good.
I don't want to make this all about, you know, Mr. Heckland and the other show, but I will say this. You were one of the first people I've seen that plays both Clark Kent and Superman so believably.
Oh,
it's like, every time I see some of these, I'm like, that's a pretty boy in glasses. That's not really giving me what you want for Clark Kent. No. You're so good in both. So.
Oh, well, thank you
Before
very
you step
much.
Off yeah. that subject, though, you know this. He has never seen the Christopher Reeve movies.
I've not seen any other of the Superman stuff. I just didn't grow up with it. It wasn't a thing in my house. And then once I started playing the character, I want to do my own thing till we're done, and then I'll go back and watch all of them. I'll have a big binge watch of everything Superman when we're done. But to go back to the original question, I'm getting nervous like talking to those two. Teen Wolf movie. Playing Derek as a dad, it's a new experience because there are fewer rules with it. I think Derek and Clark have a lot of similarities, but also a lot of differences. Their upbringing was different. Their life experience has been very different. So it was fun to, I was shooting simultaneously. So to be able to go back and feel that dynamic with the kids, but in such different ways, was really fun because they kept it super fresh each time I would go to each set. So. It was really fun to see how Derek had evolved. He had such a great evolution on the show from where he started to where it finished. It was really fun to pick it back up with him, not so concerned about himself and his journey, but about his son's journey. So that was really fun.
And so all of the horrible things they did to you, now they're doing to your son. I see where this is going. We're going to take it to the audience now. And I believe, oh, there you are. Sorry, I've never been up here, so I literally didn't know where to look. So here we go. Hi.
Hello. How are my favorite alphas doing?
Fantastic.
Good to be back.
Nice. Is where your character ends up at the movie where you wanted them to end up?
Oh, I guess I'll start with Heckland, yeah.
When we start or when the movie ends? When the movie starts or ends?
Ends.
I can't answer that.
Well, maybe this. Let me reframe it. Let me help you out. Do you think that you are, like, how do you feel about where your character is at the end of it? Can you give us, like, a one-word thing on that?
No.
Ah!
That's my one word.
I tried.
Fuck, yeah, that's a hard one to answer.
Damn.
Posey, I'm watching you.
Gotta be really strategic.
He's right here.
Every muscle in my body is poised to attack.
No. They're not where I
Next
thought.
Next question.
They didn't end up where I thought it was gonna end up.
It's an exciting ending. We'll put it that way. It's an exciting ending, but we don't want to give away any.
I'll say one thing. Story. It's an emotional ending.
Everybody in the front row just groaned so loud when he said that. They're like, oh, sorry. I know, he's very, you know, I feel for us. Yes.
Hello, my name is Nayobi. I was wondering if did you enjoy more filming the series or the movie?
Oh yeah, which one do you enjoy more filming?
I don't know. It's really hard to say. It was the same, we had mostly the same crew with us for the movie that we did for, you know, the TV show, so it was full-on family coming back and doing it with everybody together again. We have some people here, we have a producer here somewhere, and their kids that grew up on the show with us, and now they're like adults, and so being back with family was always great. I think they're one and the same. I loved both so much, you know?
All right, well then both. Let's go to our next one. We want to make sure we get as many of these as we can, yeah. Go ahead.
Hi, how are you?
Hello.
Hi.
My name is Felicia. My question is for Tyler Squared.
Nice.
My question is, what were you most excited about when you got the call for the Teen Wolf, the movie?
Yeah.
That. The fact that it was Teen Wolf, the movie, coming back, I was blown away. I was down to do anything. You could have killed Scott off in the first 3 seconds and like, please, let me be a part of it.
I think it was just knowing that we were going to see each other at work again. Like I said, I've got so many of my best friends from this show, so to know that we were all going to be at work together again was just, I mean, that was the coolest moment for me. And also genuinely knowing that the fans have asked for it for so long, for something more of Teen Wolf, to know that they were going to actually finally get that was also very, very cool.
Yeah, we're super excited for you guys to be a part of this with us, you know? Like, we literally couldn't have done it without you guys screaming every day on social media, we want more Teen Wolf! So, that's the coolest part, yes. That you guys get to have more.
I'll say getting people back together was one thing, but we also got to introduce new characters, and it's always been amazing to watch these guys work with new actors and the way they welcome them into the show and into the movie. Vince immediately felt like part of the show.
Yeah.
And Amy, who plays Hikari, she was fantastic as well. And it's kind of amazing to me because most actors leave a show and they're like, all right, I'm done with that. But these guys, it's still part of their lives. It's still a huge part of their lives. And some of the actors are pitching me spin-offs. And I'm like, guys, I don't own the rights. You're pitching to the wrong person. But they're so invested in their characters and they love them so much. So that makes it a true pleasure to come to work. When you know that the actor there wants to do a great job and wants to tell this story and keeps coming back at you with questions like, well, what's in his head right now? Or what is she feeling at this moment? That's an amazing experience. That's what I'm incredibly grateful for.
Well, thank you. I'm grateful for you putting the band back together because, like, legit, this is the best day ever.
And usually putting the band back together is hard because they often hate each other.
No, I know.
But these guys love each other. I don't get it. I don't like any of them.
Look at that face. How could you hate that face?
We have another question over here.
Hi, my name is Brianna. I just wanted to say I had the biggest crush on you, Teleposy, as I was watching Teen Wolf.
Don't we all?
Definitely. But anyways, I wanted to know how your experience on Teen Wolf has influenced you personally.
Oh yeah, that's a great question. How has your experience influenced you personally?
Oh my god. It changed my life completely. Like Hecklin said, we've been acting since we were 6 years old. You know, little kids, and have always wanted to be, you know, successful in our careers. I think that's why everybody has a career. But this, you know, I've never had a room full of thousands of people screaming for us. You know, like it changed my fuck yeah, dude. It changed my life in so many ways. I got to grow as an actor. I got to meet some of my favorite people I've ever had the pleasure of being with in my entire life. And the Teen Wolf has also given me like awesome opportunities. Like Jeff said, we're producers. I got to direct an episode. This show, just Jeff specifically, has always been one to want to help elevate somebody and help them live out their goals and dreams and aspirations. And without Jeff on the show, I don't think either of us would have had that opportunity to you know, evolve our career and see what we're made of. And so I owe a lot to Teen Wolf. It really helped me become the person I am today, you know. And I went through a lot of hard times during the filming of Teen Wolf. Like my mom passed away like 7 years ago, so it was during the middle of Teen Wolf. And just having that be with me and not so much a distraction, but just something that was always there with me. It, you know, I hold Teen Wolf close to my heart, really, like intensely. And so, yeah, it's just always been there for me.
Oh, and I will say too, it's part of his family, actually. His dad was in the show, is going to be in the movie, and Jesse Posey, his brother, is in the movie.
Yeah.
And we gave him a funny role, and he's fucking hilarious.
My brother's the best part of the movie. He's so fucking funny. And my dad plays Dr. Fenris. You guys know Dr. Fenris from Eichenhaus? That's my real dad.
And actually, I said this wrong. I said getting the band back together, but no, thanks for the family reunion. That's a better way to put this, so thank you. Next person.
Hi, I'm Dasha. I was just wondering, what's your favorite memory after being apart for so many years?
Ooh, yeah. Actually, I'll give that to you, Mr. H over there. See if you say, maybe Jeff too. I'm sure you got a bunch.
Memory. I think honestly that so many of us came back. I think that was really the cool thing. It's one thing for us to, you know, spend a lot of years coming here and saying that we're a family and, you know, that we're so close and we love each other, but to have so many people actually come back and be there to do it all over again was really special, because that's kind of like it's putting your money where your mouth is. So for us to get it back together and to do it all over again, to come here and it's just, yeah, I think it just really kind of cemented that we always meant that. And it wasn't just saying it to sound good at the time or because in the moment it was cool. Like it genuinely was a family. So it was really cool to have everybody back.
Jeff, from you, do you have any good memories as far as like being on set, the reunion aspect of it?
The reunion part of it, there's some good memories. I wasn't on set that much because I was still writing the script. But hearing them speak in the voices again was amazing to me. Hearing those words like the alpha and things like that that we hadn't written in a long time, it was crazy. My best memories from the show really always have been when I've written a scene and a couple weeks later or that morning, it's acted. And Eklund's laughing because he's like, it was always that morning.
Can I tell one quick story? So that actually is a favorite memory of mine. I think it was the end of season two, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I remember this happening. We're sitting there, and I think it was a scene between Colton and Holland. Yeah. And Jeff was over there, he's like, okay, now you say this. And Colton said the line, and he goes, okay, now Holland, you say this. And they actually did this.
It was a great fucking scene, wasn't it?
It was a great scene. It was a great scene. I remember you like writing it verbally as we were shooting it on our last night of season two. It was the most amazing thing I'd ever seen.
Season two was rough.
It was great. It was awesome.
By the way, that is not unusual for TV.
It is very not unusual. In fact, I did a conversation with Aaron Sorkin like right before, and he was like, oh, it's great. I'm here with West Wing people, and nobody is staring at me looking for a script. It's amazing. It was like a little reunion thing. Right over here.
Hello? I had this question for a long time. After season two, whatever happened to Jackson? Also, Tyler Hecklin, I love you.
I didn't hear that last one.
I love you, Tyler Hecklin.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate
it, man. So somebody was asking about Jackson. That's all on you.
Colton Haynes is in the movie. He was in the trailer. And I can tell you it was really fun to write his scenes again because it's the same old Jackson. It really is.
Does he come back with a
that
London
slimy
accent?
Slimy little bastard.
No accent, but just as much attitude.
Just as much attitude? Yeah. Love that.
I think when Colton saw some of his lines, he was like, yeah, these are good. These are Jackson lines.
Yeah.
He gets a lot of the humor. He gets a lot of the snarky remarks.
Dig that. We have time for one more. I'm so sorry, I know.
Hey, Tyler Posey, a huge fan, grew up watching the show.
Sweet.
Question for all of you. Do you feel that the show in general with this movie has ended in a good way, or do you feel that it could continue on with some of the characters into a new Teen Wolf show?
Holy shit.
That sounds like a Jeff question.
Yeah, it's very much a Jeff question because these guys want to stay employed, so I'm going to help them out and give it to Mr. Davis.
I'll tell you that there is discussion of doing more.
Well,
holy shit!
I want to get into
on you guys. Everybody sign up for Paramount Plus.
Yes.
My corporate
do.
Overlords will be very happy to have heard that.
Yes, download Paramount Plus now.
Yes. And if I do have to shout out too, I think in the audience is another Paramount Plus. He has a little show called Players, so I'm going to embarrass him real quick right now, but it's all in the Paramount family. So yeah, check out that one as well. I do have to say this, before we talk about more within maybe the Beacon Hills universe, because that's what I'm calling it. Tyler P., do you have anything upcoming you want to shout out for folks to keep an eye on?
I mean, well, what Teen Wolf helped me do was figure out what else I love to do as, you know, somebody in the film business. And I love writing, I love directing, I love producing. So I've got, like, my own projects coming up and cooking, and hell yes! So I'm very excited to share that with you guys whenever that happens. But also, I'm a musician, I've got music going out. And, fuck yeah! And I post a lot of pictures of my dogs on Instagram if you guys want to check that out.
By the way, the next one of your dog pics is my most anticipated of all the two. Let's hear it. I love it. Tyler H., sir. I mean, I think we kind of know a few of your projects. We would have to be blind at Comic-Con to see them, obviously.
Yeah. We'll be going back up to Vancouver in September for season 3 of Superman and Lois. We'll be doing that. That'll be fun. And then, I mean, apparently there's talks about more of this stuff, so you never know. And then, like Posey said, I'm really enjoying the process of putting things together, so I am working on things. I can't say anything yet. I confirmed that earlier.
I can confirm he's working on something big.
So I'm really excited about that, producing, writing. So we'll see whenever I can actually tell you about it, I'll tell you about it. But it's been a really fun process and looking forward to doing more of that.
I will say this, since we've already decided that I want to see more in this universe, if there was anyone you could fan cast in either another you know, Teen Wolf movie or whatever, who would you guys want to have come along for the ride? Anybody you'd want to like have in this world?
Have you guys seen the new Halo?
Yes.
I love that show so much. I would have Pablo be Teen Wolf as Master Chief.
Yes. Let me just
Master
say,
Chief
if you haven't seen
a werewolf.
Yeah. By the way, ladies, I'm just going to go ahead and say, he's another one that I would love to see in the costuming of Teen Wolf. That is all I was saying.
Which is shirtless, right?
Yeah, very, very much.
By the way, you just plugged a Paramount Plus show.
Yeah.
I love Halo. I literally, as soon as it came out, I watched them front to back, and it's the greatest.
I would too. Yes. Mr. H, anybody? Tyler H, sir?
Oh, man.
I want to know who could play a Superman villain.
I know.
Oh, that'd be fun. Actually, I know a name, but I can't say anything. It's so frustrating. I have great answers. I just can never actually tell you guys. so we'll see if that comes out soon or not. I don't know. Honestly, I had so much fun. Like Jeff said, we were so lucky with the new cast members we had on our show that, I mean, there's a lot of amazing actors out there that I could say that you would know, but it was such a fun experience to welcome some new people and see them in these roles. I'd just love to see who we could get some more like fresh faces in there, and because this was such a great experience this time around. I'd love to do it again.
I mean, I think I can think of a few. I mean, I think just, like, Jeff, you would have, like, obviously a running list just on people. Like, you've already talked about how Superman was an inspiration. Was there anybody else that falls under that line that you'd want to bring in?
Yeah, there's a few, but, I mean, everybody knows that, like, for Teen Wolf, Buffy the Vampire Slayer was a huge influence. I loved that show. So I always thought it would be kind of amazing to like see if we can bring Sarah Michelle Gellar back to a horror show.
I mean, but would she ever like say to herself, I'm gonna give up hunting vampires to hunt werewolves? Like, do you think that's even a possibility?
Actually, yeah. Because she just started shooting in Atlanta with us on our new show, Wolfpack, and she's actually here.
Yeah, so I believe, do I get to say welcome to the stage, Sarah Michelle Gellar? Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, Buffy herself.
Did you believe it?
I just wanted to use this opportunity to announce that I am officially changing my name. I will now be known as Tyler Michelle. And that was one of the rules of joining a Jeff show. So I now consider myself Tyler Tripled.
That's right.
I mean, first of all, just like, the still my heart, because I'm on stage with Superman, Buffy, and Teen Wolf, so I'm done. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you, Paramount Plus. But how excited are you? Because I'm dying.
I mean, I only came here because they told me that they booked Hall H, and I'm like, yeah, I'll do the show if I can visit here. It's amazing. He's amazing, and everything that these guys said about family and the atmosphere of a show that Jeff runs is really true, and I hope that, you know, I hope you guys come join us.
Jeff. Stay tuned. All right, everyone. That is it for us. Please go forth and tell people of the greatness. We're gonna take a quick photo, and I wanna thank all of you. I wanna thank the folks at Paramount Plus, and of course, our incredible panel. Thank you all.